FM News. On point. The news on XFM, I'm Chris Tim. The National Resistance Movement's legal director, Oscar Kihika, has attacked members on the opposition for pinning the Chief Justice, Alfonso Wenyidolo, over his recently concluded meeting with the president last week. This comes after a number of opposition members mounted social media attacks against the Chief Justice, Alfonso Wenyidolo, saying that he might not give them justice in the case where the NUP President Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu is challenging President Museveni's win in the recently concluded general elections. While addressing the press at the party headquarters, Councillor Oscar Kihika said that the judiciary is one of the three arms of government, adding that the Kyagulanyi case cannot stop government business, saying that the opposition must revise their conduct.
You've got to understand one thing, that the business of government does not stop running because there's an election, there's an election petition, because the judiciary is one arm of government. The executive is the other arm of government, and parliament is the other arm of government. All these arms are continuously interacting with each other. So that's government business. Just because the Chief Justice and his team went and met the president of that day, you'll recall there are justices, when they're being sworn in, they swear to deliver justice without fear or favor, and they do it.
He added that as the NRM legal team, they are set to defend President Museveni's victory, come what may.
Very crucially, we are waiting to see how many affidavits are going to be filed by the petitioner. The number of affidavits are the ones that actually determine the volume of work that is on our hands going forward. So at this point, nonetheless, we remain on standby and we are doing further work.
The elderly persons in the city have asked government to provide them with health insurance, saying that many of them are losing their lives due to lack of money for medical services in hospitals. This led by those from the Kampala Central Division, led by their chairperson, Habib Ramangana, said that it's time for them to have a health insurance arrangement from government, saying that they are old people suffering from chronic diseases, thus calling for a lot of attention from medical doctors, thus expenses.
Majority of us are suffering from one disease or another. Let KCCA hospitals create special tables for the elderly, whereby they can immediately access counseling and guidance from doctors. Let government also consider to establish medical insurance, generally for all elderly people in the country, because we are very few.
Meanwhile, Ramangana has also asked the government to secure them a loan scheme for the elderly persons in the city to enable them to invest in business so as to easily enable them access their needs.
We have some elderly people with their land where they can put some small farms. Let government give them those soft loans. As we have some retired elderly people, let government use them because they have the experience, they have the know-how. So instead of going to beg from government and relatives, government can give them those small contracts.
The town clerk, Masaka City, John Bahengana, has called for the increased budgetary allocation to the newly created cities to allow them operate to capacity. He says Masaka City alone is currently operating below capacity due to the huge mandate loaded to its status. He says that out of the 500 billion shillings budget, the city local revenue only collects 4 billion shillings, which makes it operate with a huge deficiency with no capacity to fulfill its mandate. He says that if government considers increasing their budgetary allocations, this will help them to handle urban management, which is currently not easy due to lack of resources.
We don't have the necessary capacity to manage the mandates. A critical mandate is urban management, and urban management involves the removing of solid waste from the households where it is generated and taken to areas where it should be. So we don't have the necessary capacity, the logistics, right vehicles. We can't manage to pay the right manpower. So we are operating below capacity. We had a municipality where we were giving service. Now the jurisdiction of this municipality has been expanded. We still had challenges and we have received added areas to service.
On to world news. Japan's economy surged in the fourth quarter of 2020, but it wasn't enough to keep the country from negative growth for the year. The economy beat expectations to grow by 3% between October and December compared to the same period the previous year, 2019. But growth was considerably slower than in the previous quarter when the economy expanded 5.3%. Japan's economy shrunk 4.8% over the full year, its first contraction since 2009. The growth figures come as Japan's Nikkei index briefly hit 30,000 for the first time since 1990. In sports, Manchester United forward Anthony Martial was racially abused on Instagram after his side's 1-1 draw at West Brom on Sunday. It is the second time in 3 weeks that Martial has been targeted, while teammates Marcus Rashford and Exo Tunzube have also faced racism online. Facebook, which owns Instagram, said last week it would not ban a user who racially abused Swansea's Jan Danda. And that's the latest XFM News. XFM News on point.